Welcome everyone to Wintergatan Wednesdays. Today I'm going to finish one of the more straightforward sub-assemblies on the Marble Machine X. The treadle pedal.
To power the Marble Machine X, I can use either the crank or the treadle pedal. Using the pedal frees up both my hands to play the music instrument, and it also gives me a break from cranking the machine with my hands.
There are some issues with the treble pedal that I want to fix today. Issue number one, this part is too weak, so we have to beef up this angle here. Issue number two, the pedal moves too much side to side. It can get stuck under here, and it's just a flimsy feeling. Issue number three, the metal is twisting a lot. So these two straight pieces are going like this when I apply force on the side. The last problem is a safety feature that I got from a YouTube comment, which is great. Look here. If my foot gets caught underneath, the pedal can flex this way. If it didn't flex, my toes would just become a pancake. But look what happened when we play fast. Here you can see how flimsy this action is. I want to basically be able to put my whole body weight on this without the pedal skimping around like that. Let's do it. This is supposed to be a cloud. So problem number one, it's too weak in this bend. So I'm planning to weld on some diagonal supports on the inside here. But first I need to bend this a little bit like this to avoid the pedal hitting the floor because it's been crooked from me stamping on it. Little fire, wood and welding is perfect combination.
I have been watching A-Bomb79 repair a lot of damages like this. He just fills it in with weld and then grinds it down again. I did a hack job out of this, as per usual, but it's structurally fine. I'm going to try to make a good weld, so I'm cleaning the metal with an angle grinder and technical acetone.
So, Martin's first perfect TIG weld ever. Take 200. Is presentable. It's nowhere near as beautiful as the pros make it, but I'm happy with it. So, the first problem, that it was too weak in this joint, is now fixed with these two diagonal support bars. Fixed. So now I wanna address the problem that it twists, and I'm gonna weld some pieces in here to create a kind of an I-beam. I'm going extremely carefully here now. I don't want to break this tap. I bet you all just waiting for the click, don't you? So everyone who have commented about using a tap handle, you all were right all the time. Now I'm going to try to use the molten weld puddle to melt the filler rod and not the arc. See how that looks.
Another tip I picked up from welding tips and tricks is to keep the hot filler rod inside the argon flow to protect it from becoming contaminated by the oxygen in the air. And the resulting weld is a 2 out of 10. But I know what I'm aiming for.
These are my crossed I-beam things, here, 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 and here. I also put one there. Let's cross out another problem. Twists. Let's move down and look at this. Safety feature springs back at high tempos.
To solve this, I'm gonna work with my new favorite material, spring steel.
Spring-loaded puncher. Boom. I want an M6 bolt through this, so I'm using a step drill to drill up this hole to 6 mm. And that's 6. The step drill gives you automatically this nice chamfer. Doesn't center the hole on the piece for you though. So the spring steel will be here and prevent that pivot. I'm just gonna dab smallest click of medium strength Loctite in the threads there. Oversized washer. So the spring steel's function is to allow this to pivot if my foot is getting caught under the pedal. But when we're playing the machine at really high tempos, this will keep the pedal stiff. Let's put a kick drum to that. Awesome! That is the safety feature springs back at high tempos. Done. Moves sideways is the last problem we have. And I have a plan for that. So 92 long. This is POM, also known as Delrin. It's a great bushing material. You can have things sliding on it. First of all, I'm gonna use a center drill to transfer these holes from the metal plate to the POM. Thanks to Toby for the center drills.
Here I'm cutting some of the sides of the POM block manually on the CNC machine. I'm doing this more and more, so I'm not going into the computer and making any G-code. I'm just putting the block down on the CNC bed and cut them by hand. This actually works great and it's actually really fun. Here I'm cutting the recess for the hex nuts. I'm using a 6 mm bit to rough it out and then a 2 mm bit to get into those corners. And the hex nuts fit perfect, very satisfying.
So this plate is a mounting plate that I need to weld on to the foot. So I'm gonna mount this POM block temporarily and then I'm gonna try it on the machine. And then I'm going to decide what shape to make this block in. I've shortened the screw up there. So there's a preload where the pedal pushes itself to here. Then you have this POM Delrin block gliding along this leg. One thing left to do. We have to cut this block down there to shape. If we go to the lowest position, there. Then I feel I want it to cover half the pillar. Let's do a diagonal and then half the pillar. And height wise, I only need actually something like that. Okay, I'm running down to the CNC machine to freehand cut this block. Can you check up on Wilson and Evil Wilson in the meanwhile? Thank you. Behave now. Ta-da! How much faster things go when you don't cut it perfectly with angles and stuff. I'm getting less and less perfectionistic with stuff, and that's really important if I'm ever going to finish this machine. It's just endless. Episode 81. I could never have guessed. Look at this. I don't hear anything from this sliding here. Okay, let's check our list. 2 weak. We fixed that. Moves sideways. It doesn't anymore. And the pedal feels really stable. Good. Twists. it's stable enough. So that's fixed. And the safety feature springs back at high tempos. Somewhere here is maximum, I think. It doesn't. It works. So, all done. Since the treadle pedal is also in rhythm with the music, I can just stand to the beat of the song, basically, when playing. That's great. Thank you so much for following this build. It takes forever, but I will finish it a beautiful day. This is the Marble Machine X, and today we completed the treadle pedal that is ready for the world tour. Have a wonderful day, everyone.